Yo, what's going on? This is the NRW, where we don't stop, we keep it moving. It's your boy, Kuyapi, a.k.a. Patrick Michael Strange, back with the weekly, talking about film and TV and streaming with the homies. And as you see on the screen, first up, who's going to level us up before we begin this conversation, the blur dad himself, Mr. Glenn Lawrence. What's good, Glenn?
What's going on? Top billing today. Let's go. Woo!
2022, I gotta move you up.
Well, I mean, it is February, right?
And of course, the man who's so cool, who's a chilling with the dope Rocky jacket. We see you with that, Rob. It's Mr. Rob Medina. What's good, Rob?
Oh man, this is a great way to start off the show, man. We are in a good spirits right now, so I'm really happy about that. And to do it with you guys means the world.
Hell yeah, same. And of course, my brother from another mother, from Kuya and the Kid, who's from Loy Lee Comedy. It's Mr. Loy Lee. What's good, Loy?
Hey, that is me. I we said it before. I want to say it again. Everyone, look at Kuya P's drip. That is not the Gap. I'm going to let you know that is like a hoodie, mock neck, sweater. Is it cashmere? Is that cashmere, sir?
I just wear what my wife gives me. That's all I can say.
Yo, what was that nickname you gave him before we started here, Blur Lawyer?
The Kuya GQP.
Yeah.
I can dig it.
I love that.
Yo, does she contract out? I need drip too. I'm sure we can all drip.
You know, I'll find out. At least we can roll together. You know what I'm saying? We got to do his couples trip anyway, so I'll let you know, Glenn.
The mock neck. I love that. Squad.
Mock neck hoodie, cardigan, sweater.
I don't even know if I can even rock
all of the things.
Yeah. All right, man. Well, how y'all living, man? How y'all living since I seen y'all last week? What are y'all watching? Anything changing up? Still loving Peacemaker. I know Rob earlier before we started rocking said he started getting into it. Boba Fett's killing it. What about y'all? I know Ozarks, I think, as well. Y'all binging last combo.
Yeah. 1883. Best writing out there. There is not a better Western series, period, point blank, period.
Okay. Tyler Sheridan getting that respect, huh?
Amazing. And it bothers me that you can't binge it. Oh, I can't binge it. I have to wait another week and then another week.
Right?
Who does that?
I'm gonna have to catch up. What about you, Glenn? You binged all of Ozarks, I think, already.
All of Ozarks. I'm all caught up. It was a wild ride. No spoilers. I'm very excited for the finale because I think this is the last season of it.
Yeah.
So they did a part one, which was seven. Each season has been 10 episodes, but they did a part one, which was seven episodes. And I'm guessing the part two is going to also be another seven episodes to finish off the series. So I'm excited about that. But I started watching a new series with Kristen Bell's The Girl in the Window, The Girl Across the Street from The Girl in the Window or whatever.
On like, Netflix, right?
I saw that when I logged into Netflix. Yeah. Is it good?
Yeah, it's like number one in the country right now.
So it's good.
Yeah, so apparently it's good. I've heard a lot of people talking about it. So I'm like, all right, let me check it out. And I watched the first episode. I'm like, this is it's a weird vibe. It has like that scary movie, like spoof movie vibe. But at the same time, it's very dramatic and very like, you know, like real. So I'm interested to see how they go and like if it's going to get really zany or if it's going to be really cerebral, like what type of.
So it's a horror comedy?
Yeah, it's like it says a dark comedy. And I think what happened was they didn't have that on the description. So everybody didn't know how to take it. But as soon as they changed the description to be like, it's a dark comedy, blah, 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 it shot up to number one.
I'm intrigued.
I don't know. That's what I saw.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I'm intrigued. What about you, Rob Medina? So Peacemaker is your cup of tea?
Yeah, man. I started watching that with my wife this past weekend, and we both were hooked from episode one all the way up to episode five. So by this time we're recording, episode six will be dropping this week. So I'm definitely going to be watching that. And then I just saw on Netflix the new Kevin James movie that was produced by Adam Sandler called Home Team, which is like loosely based on the true story of the New Orleans head coach.
Yep. Sean Payton.
Yeah. What was it? What was his name?
Sean Payton.
Oh, Sean. I think you said Trump Payton. Oh, yeah. Sean Payton. That was actually a good movie. I liked it. It's not going to be a film for everybody. I know that right off the bat, but it's a fun little movie that I enjoyed. I was trying to get my wife to watch it. She was like, fuck off. And I was like, all right.
Was it comedy?
Yeah, it was comedy.
Okay.
About the New Orleans Saints head coach?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
So, when he was suspended, remember?
Yeah. So he got suspended for basically allowing hits. So mm-hmm. they're saying like, oh, if you put this person out, you put hit on this guy, you're gonna get money. Bounty, putting bounties on.
Oh shit! I might have to check that out because I was a fan of this. I like the Saints and
who that?
I might have to peep that. I'm intrigued now. Okay.
You know, do you remember Bounty Gate? You remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what this movie is like. It takes up after him being suspended. He goes back to Texas to be with his son, and he ends up coaching. Well, technically, he's the offensive coordinator for his son's team, and then brought them to the championship. So I don't know how much of it is all true, but it's based on his story.
His high school team he brought to the championship. Or
I can't remember if it was a high school. I should know because I just saw it like last night. Yeah, it was like a some sort of like club league of some sort. But yeah, I think it is high school. You might be right.
All right. Well, I got some things to watch now. Okay, I see. Yeah. Thank y'all, fellas. Y'all ready to break down what's new this week?
Let's do it.
Do this.
Yes. All right, this here week. We go. Let's go. In limited release, we have Harper. And I'm just going to go through this list quick because I really want to focus on the trailers. We're going to check out some new trailers for these films that are dropping this week. So I'm going to just go through this list. We have Harper in limited release. The Beatles Get Back, the Rooftop concert. It's a nice. One day only in theaters for in IMAX. So check out your local theaters if you are a Beatles fan and you want to check that out. Because it's Peter Jackson behind it. And that's kind of dope. Peter Jackson getting on there to rock the Beatles. They, Them, Us. We actually talked about that last week. So I guess they pushed it. So that's on video, on demand, and digital this week. On Netflix, we have the Tinder Swindler. It's a documentary, and we'll actually be checking out the trailer for that. So stay tuned. Glenn, I know you're talking about the Ozarks. This is a new film in limited release called The Ghosts of the Ozarks. Not sure if it's related. I'm pretty sure it's just about that area of the world. But The Ghosts of the Ozarks is in limited release. And nationwide release, we have Jackass Forever. We already did a trailer react to this film. So you can check out that on the site, but I'll probably be checking that out. I'm still a Jackass fan. So Jackass Forever is nationwide this week as well. We also have Moonfall in nationwide release. We'll check out the trailer for that. The brand new film with Halle Berry in limited release. We have The Air Doll. This looks so weird. And so we're going to check out the trailer to this. So stand by for that. The Air Doll. Alone With You is in limited release. In Prime Video, we have Book of Love. In limited release continuing, we have Last Looks. We'll actually be checking out the trailer for that as well because that has Mel Gibson and Charlie Hunnam. So stand by. Also in limited release, we have The Last Survivors. Shout out to Alicia Silverstone. Still getting film work. She was in a film last week, and now she has a film this week. Look at Alicia go.
Oh, girl.
Right? Also in limited release, we have Lingui, The Sacred Bonds. Continuing limited, we have The Long Nights, The Wolf and the Lion, The Worst Person in the World. No, that doesn't star Glenn Lawrence, but because he's the best person in the world. And last but not least, we have Through My Window that's coming to Netflix. There you go. Those are all the films.
Where'd that come from?
Hey, just to fuck with you, bro.
That's hilarious.
There you go. Those are all the films. Y'all ready to check out the trailers, y'all?
Oh, please. Let's check out The Worst Person in the World first.
Nah.
let's check out that Alicia Silverstone. Is this better than a...
We're skipping that one. We're going to go to the weird one. All right. The weird one is called Air Doll. When y'all see this, when I read the description, I was like, what the what? Here we go.
Five nightmares. It's on you.
It's not that lines, but here we go.
Japanese.
Oh,
subtitles. What the fuck? Sex doll.
Oh, nice. Exactly.
He's marrying a sex doll. Oh,
damn.
I see.
Titties out. Yeah, doll titties.
Oh, she blushes.
Comes alive. Oh, Jesus. Okay.
Yep.
Oh, he's about to get deep in there.
Oh.
It's alive.
Now she's back. Guys, is this Pinocchio?
I'm a real boy.
I know, right? And then Geppetto. No, what? Geppetto's a pimp.
Geppetto's a pimp.
Jesus, what are we talking about? Oh, yeah, she sees multiple of her.
You know, these are the movies that these sex dolls, when they do become sentient, are going to watch and figure out life about.
This is how they're going to
get history. That actor looks so familiar.
Yeah, it looks like the girl from Squid Game.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken.
No, she doesn't want to be kissed. That's sad. That sucks, dude.
Oh, that's what weird. What the fuck was that?
Right? Oh, she's an air doll.
Is she deflating? What's happening right now?
Yeah, she's deflating.
Oh, hey, he blowing?
Hey, like now. Blowing her.
Hey, blow her up. He's
blowing. Hey,
we got a doll.
He's hey. Blowing her.
That's where you have to blow her up, huh? I heard that could be deadly if you blow into the hoo-ha. That it could actually...
You know, I'm actually intrigued.
I am, right?
Really intrigued with this one.
It reminds me of her a little bit.
I'll wait till actually I have something else to say. Is that it? Okay.
Oh. Yes.
I'm not mature enough to watch this. Really?
I don't think so. I think I'm just going to make jokes.
Okay.
Yeah. Entire, like, I was just trying not to talk over anybody over this because, you know, we just got ahead talking to, but I'm not mature enough to watch this in public.
So apparently it came out in 2009, but it's being re-released in the States.
Wait, it drops this week?
What?
In this week. Yes, it dropped really? This week, Glenn Morris. And so, I'm curious.
Inside joke.
Inside joke. Because that was a good one, though, because this one dropped in 2019. So,
what year is it?
No, 2009, he said. You said 2009, right?
It dropped out in 2009, Glenn.
Oh,
so and now we're in 2022.
Ago. No.
It took this long to come here, apparently.
It actually looks pretty good for being so old in theory, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those robots hold up well.
It's a blow-up doll, isn't it?
It's an air doll.
Air doll. It's called air doll. An air doll.
Are you guys going on dates with your air doll? That's my question.
I don't know, because if I had an air doll, I don't think I'd go on dates with it because I would just get a girlfriend to go on dates with. Like, that doesn't make any sense. Like,
I just never could see why guys would want to buy a blow-up doll in the first place. It just didn't seem
apparently
appealing at all.
Somebody here has an amazing wife. Okay. Shut up. I'm just saying. Somebody has an amazing relationship with their wife. Okay. Tell us more, sir.
I know, dude. You're kind of showing off, Rob, bro. A little bit.
Do y'all remember the 80s classic Mannequin?
Yeah. Yes. I have that movie.
Daryl Hannah, right?
No.
No,
it was
that's Splash.
Daryl
Hannah was in Splash. This was Daryl. Shit, now you got me confused.
Sex in the City.
Yes.
What's her name?
Samantha.
Kim Cattrall.
Kim Cattrall.
Kim Cattrall. Yes, thank you. Yes.
Yes.
Oh, but then there was also like weird.
James Spader's in that movie too, like, isn't he?
James Spader is.
Yeah, he's a villain in the movie.
Yeah,
I would definitely blow Kim Cattrall up. I'd even take her on a date.
This week?
I would do it this week.
I remember that movie. That was a good movie. That was a fun movie.
Is that what this reminds you of, Kuya P?
Because same kind of concept, you know.
Yeah.
Mannequin, air doll.
I can't remember if Mannequin was like, was she really having like existential crisis of like, this is what life is and this is what it's like to be human?
I can't remember.
I haven't seen it in forever, bro.
Yeah,
so
it's been a while since I've seen it, but I have it on VHS.
I just know the last time I was in Philly, shout out to Glenn Lawrence, I went to the actual place that they had the store Chocolate that they did the Mannequin.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you know that's in Philly, right, Glenn?
I did not know that. No.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah.
Right there in the center of Philadelphia Center. Like,
I also like my wife, so I did not investigate further. I just yo, listen.
Mannequin was a film my wife really enjoyed. That's why we went there and why I'm aware of it.
So. Nice. Listen, Air Doll comes alive. The first question I'm asking is, how much do you remember? Like, what?
I want to apologize.
I thought that you were just an inanimate object.
All right. Let me transition from Air Doll to our next trailer. For people also that have to get online to find women, the next film we're checking out is the Tinder Swindler.
Wow.
So there's your transition, y'all. Here we go.
I'm noticing a trend. Theme going on over here.
Yeah, it's like, so you want to talk about everything
on Tinder? Is this like the rural juror? Hard to say.
Can change your life.
I
only miss
you when it rains. I was a doc.
When I first talked with Simon, immediately we had a bond.
That documentary is this.
Is everyone going to be attractive in this?
And very impulsive. I share my whole heart with him.
Oh, they're doing reenactments.
He asked me if I wanted to travel with him on a private jet. I was like, shit. He took me to a 5-star hotel. He said we had a special connection. It felt like stepping into a movie. And then the middle of the night.
Australian.
He said there was something he wants to tell me.
Oh, okay.
He said he has threats against him. He needs our cash. $20,000, $30,000,
$140,000. What?
Life dependent
what the
on
fuck?
Me. That's when police tell me the man I loved was never real. Everything's a lie. Who is this guy we share the same bed with?
For how long?
Then I get these threatening messages.
Take my advice. Just watch out.
We have idea what he's capable of. It's just been fucking hell. I'm just freaking out. But we needed to get payback.
Uh-oh.
We don't know how far this conspiracy actually goes.
Diamonds involved. Rome barks alone. Oh, he's in the dope spot.
It's all they're getting $30,000 from a date. Yeah, why not?
To swindle the Tinder swindler.
Say
you
that.
Love the fraud. You're gonna pay for it.
He sounds French Canadian.
This sounds exciting.
You know Bravo?
Hmm.
Interesting. There you go.
No, there's a whole world out there that I missed out when I was dating. I could have been swindling.
I mean,
I could have been in Tel Aviv right now.
It's the same makers of like, don't fuck with cats.
Yeah.
Like,
mm-hmm.
So I'm there.
About? I don't even remember that.
Oh, don't do that. Don't do it.
I've never seen that.
Is it bad? What is that about?
It's a documentary kind of like this, and it gets super messed up. No spoilers. I'm just going to tell you, you're probably not going to like it.
Really?
It's going to make it hard to sleep for a while.
So can I just jump in for a second? Cause don't fuck with cats is crazy.
Oh, like, so you've seen it too.
I saw the beginning of it. I didn't go all the way in like Lloyd did. I just was like, I don't want to go further because it's like basically a dude posts something about harming cats or whatever on like Facebook. Yep. And it's just like a small image of like an apartment room. And these people, like they figure out the paint on the wall and the speckles and like
the time and the
time of day. Yeah. Like just from this one little image, they like track.
Oh, dude, I did watch
the
that
F down.
I watched that.
And it's wild.
It gets wild.
Yeah. I watched that.
I've never seen it.
It was like in Russia, these kids and shit, right?
He might have been the kid. Yeah. He might have been.
Yeah. Yeah.
Crazy.
It's wild, but okay. It's the same makers apparently, according to the trailer. So I know it's going to be top notch, but horrific.
Yeah.
I'm intrigued with this documentary though.
Yeah. Listen, I've been out there dating. I'm like, I'm paying for dates. Meanwhile, I could have been swindling hundreds of thousands of dollars on my Tinder date. Like I was like, Tinder owes me money at this point.
So you wouldn't watch it, Loy and Glenn, because you already know like it's just evil shit and there's just evil people in the world. So
no, I'd watch this for sure.
Yeah, I was gonna say I am a glutton for that kind of pain. So yes, let's
so do it. Okay, so you are all too. Yeah. So everybody's tuning in. Okay.
Yeah, amen. I'm tuning in.
Amen.
All right. Well, let's give last looks on that and now transition to the last looks trailer. How about that?
Oh, okay.
Segway second to none.
I'm going to direct this verdict and find this here defendant
LA.
Guilty. God!
Alistair, that was terrific.
Hilarious.
Terrific bloody genius. You're not going to top that one. Wouldn't be the first time I've had the clap.
That was good.
Lorena.
Woof.
Man,
hello.
I go.
Yeah, we replaced Gal Gadot with her.
Alistair Pinch, the actor.
Killed his wife.
Can I watch them both be Wonder Woman?
Maybe he killed her, maybe he didn't. I don't think he even knows. The guy's a blackout drunk.
I deplore drinking alone, so I have a double.
The network's got a lot riding on him.
Mr. Waldo!
They're looking to hire a PI.
I'm retired.
Come on, let me bring you back into the real world.
What would I even do with the money?
Where's all your stuff?
Cut myself down to 100 things.
And you kept that hat?
Will you return to your mountain and leave me to the fates? Or will you stick around long enough to see the police maybe get it right this time?
Daddy!
Princess Ozma, where did you come from?
Welcome to Kindergartens of the Rich and Famous.
Death must have shocked the hell out of this place, huh?
Come meet me tonight.
I am digging this already. Yeah, trust me.
Why should I trust
you? I'm intrigued.
Charlie Huntsman is that's a guy.
Foster. I have gotten married, fathered children, and taken out mortgages and not remembered.
You do realize that everyone is sure you did this.
Damn. Mel Gibson. Marina. Oh, man. Look at this. Okay.
Oh, Dominic.
Dominic. Montague. Okay.
Oh, that's, what's his fucking name? Yeah. Agent 47.
I'm going to arrest you. Go put some clothes on.
Don't be silly, love. The network will adore me in this wardrobe. Anyway, if it's good enough for Wacko Jacko, it's good enough for me.
Okay. I'm digging this. I like, okay, people getting punched. Mel Gibson being crazy.
A girl just wants to have a
buckle up.
Okay.
Where's Gemma?
I'm a pacifist, and I refuse to get involved.
Have you had enough? I've had enough.
All right. There we go. Last.
That looks amazing.
That looks good.
I thought I saw Robin Givens' name in there. On that last card, I almost positive I saw Robin Givens' name. All right, never mind. Maybe I'm seeing things. Who knows? Okay. Robin Givens.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be Robin surprising.
Givens. Yeah, same here.
We haven't seen her in forever.
No, she's still around with Howard Stern. Robin Givens, right? You're talking about the same.
I'm talking about Robin Quivers.
I'm thinking Robin Quivers.
You're right. You're right, Loy.
Isn't it the same person? No.
Not all black people look the same, Robin.
No, Loy, wow. I think you're right.
Okay, because I was like Robin Givens. Okay,
yeah, I think you're right, bro.
Oh,
okay,
googling it.
Yeah, I'm fucking up with.
I looked at
I'm
it. Yeah,
of the wrong Robin. Might be
Fontella Davis is her name in the movie.
Robin Givens. My bad.
Yeah. Okay. you're confusing your Robins, Rob.
Yeah,
Robin.
Wrong Robin. I have one Robin here in the house too. So
gotcha.
Listen, I don't know
your dog.
Yeah.
I don't know about you all. But I definitely think Marina, Bacarina, definitely got my vote for Wonder Woman over Gal Gadot. I think they should. I would be cool with that recast.
Replacing?
Yes.
Gal Gadot?
Yeah.
Okay.
This week?
This week.
Why would they replace her right now?
I mean, they're not. She's making the money doing the thing or whatever. I personally have just not been a fan.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You have said that in our past.
I'm like, yeah.
You have said that.
I want to like it, but I'm not liking it.
I'm fine with Gal, but I think Marina, definitely, I'm looking forward to her getting more. We did see her in the Deadpool stuff.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, she was great in that.
That's where she is. Yes,
she's lovely.
She was also in Gotham, too. With her husband.
Really? Who's her husband?
The guy plays Jim Gordon. Ben McKenzie or something like that, whatever his last name is.
What?
Yeah, that's her husband.
Rob, I love you. You always have the deep cuts.
Oh,
well, I just can't figure out who my Robins are. That's the only caveat. Fucking up all my Robins here.
Red Robin?
All right, y'all.
That I know for sure, but no.
Yum.
We have one last trailer for this episode. Y'all ready to check that out?
I thought that was the last look.
No, it wasn't the last look. The moon has to fall first, Glenn.
All right.
That's the biggest film this week.
There we go.
And hopefully we'll have some stuff from your boy. I've been actually talking that some of the stuff that's got me crazy right now is I'm trying to work out some of the interviews right now.
Nice.
So stay tuned. But Moonfall, biggest film dropping this week. Let's check that out. All right.
If you're watching this, then you know by now a huge...
That?
Free bagels.
That looks like a dude I do comedy with. That looks like Eric Cucciarabi. This is not Lloyd.
Yeah, a little bit. Also looks like the guy from Game of Thrones. Really
on he is. Terms these days. The guy from Game of Thrones. Change.
Yeah, just, you know, out of Google orbit. Eric Cucciarabi for watching this.
There's no need to panic.
Not crazy!
Why are they lying about all this?
It's too late to stop.
Donald Sutherland.
Wait.
You knew all this was happening before NASA.
You are the unidentified source?
Oh, yes.
I'm sorry. There are way too many movies about, like, something from space killing us all without
us. We're planning a mission to attack.
Are they trying to tell us something?
I'm asking you for your help.
say yes, Brian.
I need you to be brave.
If the moon really is what you think it is.
She looks so good for someone in her 50s.
Okay.
You have got a big gravity wave coming your way. You have to launch now.
Did he say gravity wave?
It's a gravity wave, bro. Oh,
wave of gravity. Nice.
That's crazy.
Oh, snake.
Whoa, slow down.
Okay.
What's the plan?
Fast Save and Furious Space Saver. Edition.
Brian, what are you doing?
It's flying itself.
Wait for it.
What's happening?
Let's go, you son of a...
Yes!
Oh man.
I'm gonna get you home.
I'm gonna get you. Yeah, I can put that on repeat. I'm gonna get you home. That was a sexy distress call.
It's on airplane mode.
All right. So
I think I saw Kelly Yu in there. Sorry.
The first 5 minutes reacting to the film. I'm sorry, Loy. I wanted to just lead off with Rob because Rob did a reaction when they sent us the first 5 minutes of Moonfall. Now that you saw that and now this, what do you think, bro?
Well, I'll be honest. I still want to check out the film because I am actually a fan of Roland Emmerich, the director of the movie, who's done like Independence Day, 2012, Stargate, and just to name a few. But
be honest, man.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to be honest. Wow. All right. I've heard bad things about the movie. All right. And honestly, that was my biggest concern, that the movie was going to be look too good on paper, but wasn't going to deliver all the things that Roland has been so successful in the past with Independence Day, Day After Tomorrow, you know, to some extent, 2012. And when I heard kind of what the direction of the story, I was like, man, I'm not feeling it, but I'm going to give it the benefit of the doubt. I may watch and say, this is the greatest thing I've ever seen in my life, because I love shitty films too, as you all know. So who knows? I might walk away thinking it's the greatest movie of 2022, but I don't have a lot of hype for this movie like I anticipated, because when I first heard of the plot synopsis, I thought that was interesting. And one thing, this is actually, I did not know this until fairly recently. This is the most expensive independent movie ever made to this day, $140 million. So I don't know who spent the money on it, but whoever did, they must have believed in the story, because to spend $140 million on that film and hearing what I've heard, I don't know, but I may check it out.
Loy, I know you were trying to say something. My apologies. Go ahead.
No, that's my bad. I just like to derail conversations. That's really my job here, is just to throw monkey wrenches.
Derail away.
What do you think then, Loy?
I thought I saw Kelly Yu's name in there. So
yes,
I don't know.
She's in there.
Amazing. She's in there. So I'll watch it. I think it looks interesting, right? Was that Clarence Clearwater Revival? That's the singing. Okay, yeah, I'm there. Yeah. You sold me. Yeah. But
CCR.
I think I have an issue being like, if it starts with him being a conspiracy theorist online and then he's in space and then there's a space monster, and then they got to save the world. I feel like that's a very large gap to cover in a very short amount of time. So I'm curious. I'll watch it. It's Halle Berry, Kelly Yu, guy from Game of Thrones. I'll watch it. I'll watch it this week. Yes.
Glenn Lawrence.
It's Halle Berry, so I'm going to see it. So
yeah. Halle Berry.
That's just, there's no suspense. I'm going to watch it. I'm probably going to love it. There's a scene with Halle Berry saying, "I'll get you home," and I'm like, I'm there for that scene alone. put Can't that on repeat. You. That's what I go to bed to. it looks like Roland Emmerich just like rolled every movie he's ever done into this one movie.
Yeah. And, like, scraps
out there. It's like, let's do this. So, you know, I'm in for these big disaster movies. It's interesting. So I'm definitely going to check it out. Low expectations. So it'll probably exceed them. I just want something interesting. There's like some weird like gravity monster in there. So that's because usually his films are kind of grounded in like the reality and the science of the situation. Mm-hmm. And I just want to know, like, did he just say we need to get a little bit more
creative,
you know, supernatural, get like, you know, some superhero elements or something in there? It's like Gravitron is like the villain of this or something. I don't know.
The guy spending the $140 million was like, I like everything, but I feel like there should be like a space monster. And they were like, that's not in the script. Like, yeah, but for $140 million, I would like a space monster.
I like a space. Why can't I get a space monster? You know.
Yeah. I wonder if John Peters produced it then.
Yeah. So I'm for it, dude. I'm two thumbs up already. I think I'm going to like this movie.
It looks well done.
It does look well done. I agree with you. I do.
We love a good disaster movie, don't we? We do love a good disaster movie. Yeah.
So wait, the first 5 minutes. How was the first? Oh wait, I'm sorry. Was somebody else about to go?
This week?
Someone else about to go. Was someone else going?
Yeah, I was about to give my commentary because I didn't go exactly yet, Glenn.
I want to hear it. I'm sorry.
Queen of P, what are your thoughts?
Hey, thank you for asking, boy. For me, the first 5 minutes that I saw with along with Rob really intrigued me. It seemed like they were going to go a little bit more realistic. And but then I shouldn't count my chickens before the hatch. It was Roland Emmerich behind it. And that's, you know, I thought he was going to do a smart disaster movie. Now we're still getting a disaster movie, but I don't think it's exactly smart. It's very campish in its look. But we do. But that's what a disaster movie traditionally is. And so there's a lot of cheese. Like you said earlier, I don't know who made the comment, Fast and the Furious in space. I don't know if it was Glenn. You know what I'm saying? So Glenn, I'm like, yeah, Glenn, you're totally right. So like, we got to suspend belief. You know what I'm saying? Where I thought we were going to be a little bit more realistic. Now I got to suspend belief a little bit. Still going to check it out. Halle Berry, everybody involved. It's cheese. It's going to be cheese, but I'm for it. So now you can have it back, Glenn.
I was actually just asking what you thought of the first 5 minutes. That's what my
I thought it was dope. It's completely different than what we're seeing right now.
Yeah,
it was kind of in the trailer that they gave us those 5 minutes, and now they're giving us this full trailer, which totally changes your opinion, at least for me personally, from that first 5 minutes. Would you agree, Rob?
Yeah, I agree 100%. Because that first 5 minutes, which you can tell they kind of like condensed it from whatever it's supposed to be supposed to be original length with. But what you saw in the first 5 minutes is like. You get introduced to that weird black thing that's spiraling around. That
we know something's coming. I don't think we actually saw it.
No, we saw it in the first 5 minutes. You just don't know what it is, actually. Yeah, it just crashes right through the spaceship and then it gets into the moon and it starts to like tunnel its way through it or drill its way through it, rather. No, it's in the first 5 minutes. It's nothing crazy, but it was interesting. I was like, oh, this looks like some sort of weird possible alien destruction type of movie with them using the moon to crash Earth. So I was curious about where that all came from. But when we saw the trailers, as KP had just said before, it's two different tones, man. And that was kind of like the big wrench for me. So I'm still going to check it out. I still am excited for it, despite my reservations. But my expectations that went from like here to like below the first floor,
like to the level of Marine 2.
Fuck that. I would watch Marine 2 right now in a heartbeat.
So the question I asked the two that have seen the first 5 minutes, what would be like, is it a trailer misrepresenting the movie or the first 5 minutes misrepresenting
the movie?
Like,
yes. Yeah. The second half, first 5 minutes that they put out misrepresented what this now official trailer is giving
us. Interesting.
Yeah.
Would you be disappointed if it is actually like the first 5 minutes, like that whole movie is like the first 5 minutes and they're misrepresenting the movie in the trailer? Or do you want to see the movie that's like in the trailer?
I don't even know now, bro. Yeah. I don't even know.
Because it looks like it was a misdirection from all different angles there, because, you know, the trailer, that's the one thing about Roland Emmerich's movies as of late, where you get the spectacle, but you don't get the actual like the humanity behind the story, which was what the 5 minutes did so well. I mean, not the greatest, but it just set the tone of like, these guys are a crew and they're working together and you get something out of that. And then you see this crazy thing occur. But the trailer is just like, you know, bagel jokes and a bunch of other nonsense. And then, you know, then we get the guy taking a picture in airplane mode in space.
You know, it's interesting. I feel like these, it feels like they always have two, right? Like there's Armageddon, and then right after there was like Deep Impact. And
yeah,
it feels like they always have two of them. And then we had Don't Look Up, right? Kuya P, shout out in there. You know what I'm saying? Actor extraordinaire. And then they have like this one, which is another like kind of campy, the sky is falling, for lack of a better word. So it'll be interesting to see how they do it, because I feel like Hollywood always gives us, you know, two competing like ideas that are basically the same. And that's kind of what's happening here. So yeah. I'll be interested to check it out. Like I said, Holly Berry's in it, so I'm going to see it.
Yeah, it's like Dante's Peak and Volcano. Which would be like better?
Yeah. Yep, exactly. Yeah. Yeah. They always have two. There's always it's like Hollywood's like Costco. You get two choices. You get the Kirkland brand and the name brand.
You get the Great Value brand.
Yes, sir. All right. There we go. Those are all the trailers. We now have the last time we're going to do this, because we're actually going to do something different, y'all. So this is the last time until we launch that new show. We have clips that we share. I'm going to throw it to Loy with his clip.
Okay. I, as you guys know, I tell dick jokes for a living. Like, that's just what I do. There's a reason for that, because if I had to sit through a Zoom meeting or even like a conference call or like an actual meeting face to face, and I heard anyone talk like this, I would get fired, because I'd be firing on them, because I don't have the bandwidth to sit through anything or anyone that sounds anything like this.
All right, here we go.
Can you hear me? Control. Sorry, I was double muted. I just wanted to hop on and touch base and close the loop here. As a quick level
none of those set, words make sense to me.
I want
to
put this on everyone's radar. You may want to keep it in your back pocket. I'm going to piggyback off the first point and double click on that idea. We really need to consider the art of the possible, because we're in a unique position to launch this thing at scale, but we may need to win ugly first. So I want to make sure that we're gathering all that low-hanging fruit and striking.
Oh my God.
Out. But we can't have too many irons in the fire, because we just don't have the bandwidth. People are burning the candle at both ends, so we need to make sure that the juice is worth the squeeze. We're getting close to the top of the hour, and I've got a hard stop at 3, so if you have any questions about this, feel free to circle back with me, and I'll give you all 5 minutes back to your day. Oh, can you hear me?
There we go.
Firing on all of those people.
Mm. You know, it's interesting. I totally understood everything she was saying.
Right? Exactly.
I know you do, but I'm going to go with, you realize she literally didn't say anything. We should work harder and smarter, but less, but harder, but smarter, but, you know, figure it out. I don't know. I'm going to leave now. It's basically all I heard.
And don't call me with any questions.
Yeah, I would have definitely taken actionable items from that meeting. And I feel like I would touch base again. And I think everything is understood here. If it's not clear, we can circle back.
Okay. Growing up, you had alphabet soup and you just tried to make words out of the alphabet that's in your spoon. I feel like this is like a thesaurus grab bag mystery box. Just, I don't know, these are words, let's just say words.
Yeah,
I hated it.
Work life,
hated it.
Yeah,
that's why I can't have a real job.
And all of us were like, yeah, we've been there, done that. No,
everyone was like, so I don't get the joke. What's should I be taking notes?
No, I think we just hated our lives. I know I hate my life. Why do I understand everything like Glenn said? Yeah. And we suck. Like, this is stupid. And yeah, I hate our life.
I hate our lives.
Let's get this bad taste out of our mouth. Glenn Lawrence, why don't you present your clip?
You know, sometimes there's just a little bit of nostalgia that'll come back and it'll just reach up and just grab you, and it takes you back, and you just have to take a moment and be like a little bit in awe of it, of where you were and where you came from. And this clip is just that. It's a moment with Allen Iverson. He's out at an event, he's signing things, and he just gets hit by, you know, the memories of one of his good friends. I'm sure everybody here will know him. And it's just kind of like a really sweet moment that I think all of us kind of had the same feeling, which is just like, damn, man, miss that guy.
All right, here we go.
Incredible. Fans, just so you know, Jones is going to be moved up to 130.
Whose is this?
From 2 o'clock to 1:30.
Andrew Jones.
He was scared, you remember?
For Andrew Jones, please report to the photo booth at this time.
What you want me to sign this night? Man, you gonna give me one? You got another one from me?
I got it over there by Fetterman.
Man, I need one of these.
This one. Sell it to him.
If you look, that's Allen Iverson and Kobe Bryant back in the heyday.
What you want to
man? Number 8 Kobe. Iceberg Fro. Kobe.
A white joint.
Let me go. I can go grab another one off the table.
Can I put something up here for him?
Does he have a ski mask on him?
Yeah.
My job to be the bad guy. You can be the good guy anytime you want.
Can I put something up here?
Yeah. Damn, he's like at a loss. You don't even know what to say, man.
Yeah. AI versus the...
So that AI was it. Versus... That was just, all right.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. That's real awesome.
Love you, my man. Seriously. Hey, you do what you're supposed to be doing, business. Man? You do?
Yeah.
So you listen to him. Because I ain't listening to my dad and my mom.
Oh.
All the time.
Depends so what day it is.
You do it sometimes, right? The most important things, yeah, you listen to him. Right? All right, well, you need to, bro. Because he's been here already.
I just pop up in there.
You that little kid's like, practice.
I'm not instructing anymore. I just pop up to visit my squad guys out there.
Man, this is the dude that love you the most.
Oh.
You don't know that? All right, man. You need to get in tune. That's the
yeah.
guy.
Yo, wait. I didn't see that all last.
Right. Yeah, I never saw this one, bro.
Wow. There's he went from being extremely excited about seeing the picture to being disgusted with that little kid.
He told the
10-year-old
kid to fuck off, basically. Respect your father. Like, get the fuck out of here. Get that pen back.
But, just that was Allen Iverson with the Kobe Bryant, and it's just kind of like a moment like, damn, like that was me with my homie. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And that was heartwarming. But I didn't see the part.
It's like, I was like, where's this going? I haven't seen this one.
You need to get in tune, man.
It's like, whatever, just get out of here now. No, the moment's lost, kid.
Yeah. So I have a connection to Allen Iverson, y'all, that I'll never forget. Because, you know, Allen Iverson played at Georgetown, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And when he played at Georgetown, he played with my wife's cousin who played at Georgetown as well. They played Damian Sinclair Bolden, Damian Bolden. Mm-hmm. They played together at Georgetown. So they all went out to go hang out, you know, as college students do. And my wife went with her cousin, you know, Damien, and Alan tried to hit up on, you know, y'all know Ebony, y'all know my wife. Yeah. Alan tried to pick up on Ebony, y'all.
Oh, wow.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So that's why you were giving no commentary throughout the whole clip.
Like, I got nothing to say. You know what I'm saying? Respect. You know, obviously, Alan went nowhere with Ebony because she's now my wife. But, right. You know, back in the day, he hit on Ebony back in the day.
Damn. So.
Yeah,
that's wild, bro.
Ebony can give you more of the story. I'm not gonna take too much up.
Yo, I actually, next time we're at a party, I'm gonna have to ask Ebony. I'm like, yo, so you had a choice between Cleo P and Allen Iverson.
he's also from Virginia Beach. You were out there for a while, right?
Newport News area too. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah,
he was at Hampton
by the base. Yeah.
Yep. That was a wild time, man. That was a special
he
time.
He was the
of
man
sports.
Back there. The AI. He was the man.
You know? Yeah, that was a special time in sports and NBA, as well as his college career, everything. Yep.
Mm. That's crazy.
So anyways, RIP Kobe Bryant.
That's the anniversary was last week.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's 2 years now, hasn't it been?
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
That's COVID. Crazy.
Yo, let's get on some positive. Y'all going to get me depressed. Let's get.
But wait, this last thing. If you think about it, like Kobe Bryant's death almost like precipitated and started this whole shitstorm of the last 2 years. Like, remember, like Kobe Bryant died, and then
it's been at the beginning.
It's been crazy ever since. Like, ever since then, it's been insane.
Kobe's was holding back COVID for 19 renditions. He was just holding it back.
He was the only thing keeping us from sanity.
Yeah, that's wild, bro.
Yeah, you got a good point.
Anyway, let's get to some positive. I'm gonna throw it to Rob to close this out with his clips. What are you sharing today, Rob?
So I love, as you all know, funny videos of people doing crazy stuff. And this is just mainly about couples who are just doing stuff together that just doesn't turn out as well. And it's just for fun little giggles here. So I hope you guys enjoy
it. Well. Let's leave out with a laugh. I like this. Yeah. Here we go.
Why? Why?
Lori's like, why?
You have weights. Oh, you just headbutted.
No. All that in your face.
Yeah. Oh, this is a bet.
Ow. Try to be sexy.
This is funny. Cute. And
if you smell,
she picked him up.
Wow,
I guess. Oh man, there's one thing I don't like people doing is throwing shit on my food. I would be
furious. Don't touch my food.
Yeah.
Oh, she's gone.
She said no.
Oh, she's gone.
Oh shit, I've been skiing before. Oh no, that was like gonna hurt.
That does not look like soft snow.
I know, right?
It's like granulated powder.
I know, right? Like those crystal rocks that we've seen.
She's trying to step on the fish to keep him right there. And yeah. Okay.
And it goes back to the water.
Right?
Oh! XK. Oh, this is not going to end well.
Yeah, nah.
Oh!
Ow.
Oh, that could have been so much worse.
Yeah, I was gonna say. Yeah. Kirby!
Oh, this is gonna suck. Okay, that could have been worse too.
Yeah.
No, that too.
Like, are you serious? See?
Oh, exactly. Come on, bro.
Ooh.
She's gone.
Yep.
Dude in blindfold? Nah, see, that's a red flag right there. Come on, man.
Yeah, let's make it older, more difficult. All this stuff feels like it would take me out.
All right, let's check this last one out. Have y'all ever done that? I've done that.
Yes.
No.
Parasailing?
Oof. Yeah.
Ah. Oh, I felt that. I felt that. She can sing.
Yeah. There we go. Now you're about to fall. And now she sliced open your hand, didn't she?
Oh, that looks like it hurts.
Right.
Ow.
There we go, y'all. Those are our clips. Another week in the can. Anything else we got going on? Anything y'all want to promote? Anything dropping this week, y'all?
Nope. I got nothing. Just this. Yeah, nothing. This is the tentpole of my week.
And we still love you, Loy.
Still love you, bro.
Kids, you got anything new dropping? Hey, he's young. I hit him at the wrong time. Blur dad.
Not much. Just kids growing, trying there to raise them up. At least give them a year of entertainment from pops before I start doing stuff.
Enjoy the time, brother.
Yeah, man.
And you, Rob?
Yeah. I got a new episode this week with an actor by the name of Robert Keith. They'll be dropping. So by the time this gets uploaded here on the channel, you should already be up on the channel as well, too. And as far as anything else is concerned, I've got a review coming up, two reviews possibly coming up this week, possibly for Home Team. I'm still debating if I should do it now because I don't know. I wanted to do it and I just enjoyed it and I didn't want to get into it as far as reviews concerned, but I think I might change my mind on that. And then another film along the way this week too. So that's about it as of right now.
Dope, dope. Well, make sure you go check that out. How can they follow you? Back to you, Rob. How can they reach out to you with Mr. Yo So Cool?
So you all can follow me on my socials on Instagram, Rob_Medina0585, on Twitter, Rob_Medina0585, and on Facebook, simply just Rob Medina, and my show social media accounts on Instagram, You're So Cool with Rob Medina, and Twitter, You're So Cool with WRM.
There we go. Blur Dad, Glenn Lawrence, how can they reach out to you?
Check out levelupcomedy.com, Level Up Comedy across all your socials, Glenn Lawrence Comedy on Facebook, as well as IG, and Glenn Levels Up on Twitter.
There we go. And of course, the other comedy king, Loy Lee.
Hey, guys. How are you? What show are we doing? What are we doing? What's going on?
How can they reach out to you?
Oh, my bad.
Show you love.
Loy Lee comedy across all your social medias. Loy Lee, I've been dedicating a lot of time to my TikTok. It's TikTok. It's Loy Lee comedy. And hopefully we can do Kuya and the Kid soon. I know you're busy.
We'll make that happen.
And Mr. You're So Cool, aren't we on the books for something at some point?
Yes. Oh, shit. Yeah.
What are we supposed to watch? Annihilation? Something. No, we did Annihilation.
Yeah, we did Annihilation. I haven't uploaded it yet. Jesus Christ, I forgot about it.
Just down here waiting. Just hey, we'll take this offline. We'll circle back. Close the loop.
I completely forgot about that. Yeah. Oh shit, might be. Yeah, it's still stored away somewhere. But yes, we have something else that I wanted to review to down the line.
We'll talk about it offline. Like we said, we'll make it happen. There we go. Make sure you give them all the love, all the follows, all the subscribes. Get your laugh on with the homies and get inspired with the honies.
Cajones?
Where you put? You know what? It's getting late.
Ponies and bronies.
For me, it's the Legend Kuya P on Twitter, TikTok, and IG. Of course, Show Pal Show. NRW, New Release Wednesday, Nerds Rule the World. We up out of here because it's getting late, y'all. We up out of here. We out here.
Peace. Love you guys. Bye bye. All
right.